Hey guys, so today I'm going to do a face mask and just chat with you guys. So I'm really excited to get my, sorry for that ugly face that I just made, to get my second video up on YouTube. So I'm going to be vlogging and I'm going to, I don't know if I'm going to have a vlogging channel and like a video channel, or I'm just gonna use the same channel for everything. Maybe later on in my, like, you know, my YouTube, my YouTubeness, whatever, maybe later on I will start two different channels for vlogs and for just normal stuff. So what I'm gonna do is this video is going to be just a video. I'm going to do a face mask and I'm going to chat with you guys, and then after I do this, I'm going to go live on Instagram, on my Instagram account, and do a video on there, just a video of me doing makeup probably. I'm sorry, I'm plugging in my fan, it is so hot, I'm so tired of this hot weather. I needed a fan. Alright. So, yeah, that's what this video is going to be. So I'm going to do a face mask. So, so this is just, it comes with powder, and then it comes with this thing. You're supposed to fill it up with some water, and then mix it, and then just apply it to your face. So, I'll show you how it goes. So, it is supposed to make your face smooth and brighten. So, sorry, my hands kind of smell like bleach because I was just cleaning. But anyways, so, but this smells so good. It smells so good. I don't know if I'm going to use all of it. So, because I always say you can add more, but you can't take away. So I'm just gonna I'm gonna add some powder. Cause the first time I ever did one of these masks, I used the whole. I used all the powder and all the like water that I needed, and I tried to save it, but it dried up like in like it. This mask dries super fast, so that's why I just do a little at a time now. So. I got my little spatula here. Looks like this, just this pink little spatula. I actually like it. I'm gonna keep it for my other face mask that I use. So then I'm gonna add a little bit of water. And then I'm gonna stir it. And you have to stir it for a while until it's not chunky. And that's too watery, so I'm going to add more powder. Yeah, I think I'm just going to use the whole thing today because there's not much left anyway, so I'm just going to use it all. I'll definitely get another one of these masks because this is one of my favorite face masks to do. So. And it smells so good. I wish you guys could smell it. I would show you the packaging, but I threw it away. I will definitely tell you what it's called, though. Don't worry. I will. So I'm going to add a little tiny bit more water, just a little. So I will end up buying this mask again. And I'll show you what it looks like so you guys can try it out. I'm just kind of stirring it up and I'll show you what it looks like once it's all ready to put on my face. Make sure you get all the powder in there. You gotta make sure it's all stirred up and it's not chunky. That's what it says. It kind of looks like, like a batter, kind of like a cake batter or something like that. And you're kind of supposed to put a lot on your face. Alright, so now I've got it to where it should be. And I've kind of made a mess here. Alright, so let me show you. This is what it looks like. It's like that. So now I'm going to put it on my face. Ready for this? So, my face is clean, there's nothing on it. Wait, there might be some foundation on it actually, so let me get some wipes to take this off. Make sure that my face is clean here for this mask. Your face is supposed to be clean. So I'm probably going to pre-film a few videos, that way I can post a few a week. So I will be like pre-filming and stuff, but I will get a video out every week. That is my goal. Alright, so it's starting to dry already, so I gotta get it on my face. Alright. Of cake batter or something. And put it down like that. And it says the more that you put on, the easier it will be to peel off. You're supposed to leave it on for 10 to 15 minutes. It's so fun to put on and it feels so good. It's so cold and it feels good. So, I want to talk to you guys, of course. Sorry I'm being quiet. I'm like trying to focus on putting this on. So, you guys, I know, wonder, the people who don't have CF that are watching my videos, you guys wonder, what is CF? Why is she in the hospital all the time? What's going on? And I don't remember if I answered many questions in my last YouTube video. I don't think I did. I think it was just makeup. And that's definitely not my life. Just makeup. I'm not gonna get into everything, of course, because it will take me a while to answer every question that you guys have. And of course, I'm not the only, you know, CF YouTuber on YouTube. There are others that I watch and I love. And they are amazing as well. I watch The Fry Life. they're seeing. Well, they're a couple. And the girl has CF. I'd really like to talk to her one day. She seems amazing. Like an amazing, amazing person. And I hope that my channel can be even the least bit like hers, and inspire people like she does, because she is super inspiring, and I hope that one day maybe she sees this and realizes that she does inspire other people that have CF. And I'm starting to look crazy with this mask. I'm trying to put on as much as I can because that's what it says to do. Just put on as much as you can and it'll be easier to come off. I have been wanting to start a channel for a while. I got the idea from one of my nurses. Her name's Kim. And I got the idea from her. And she started telling me, you should start a YouTube channel. And she, at first I thought she was, just kidding. Well, not kidding, I know she meant it, but she kept getting more and more serious about it and giving me more and more ideas that I thought were really cool ideas and challenges. She gave me some really cool challenges to try. One of them is trying to do my makeup with my vest, and that would be so hard. And if you guys don't know what a vest is one of the treatments that CFers have to do and go through. And it may look like nothing, people don't understand, people that don't have CF don't understand, people would think, oh my gosh, that's a piece of cake, having to do that, doesn't seem hard at all. Why do you guys complain about that? When you have to do that 4 times a day or 3 times a day, however many times a day, every day of your life, it definitely is not a piece of cake at all. It's so inconvenient. It's not fun. Nothing about CF is fun, really, honestly. The people that you meet, that's amazing. That part is amazing, honestly. The people that you meet are people like nobody else. They're like no other. The other CF families and people that have CF, they are some of the most genuine people I've met in my life, just because they go through what you go through. They are strong like you, They know exactly what you're going through. And I hate when people try to make it a competition. So, I just used all of it. I guess that was my little challenge there for that video. That challenge is done. I used it all. But And then I'm just gonna chat with you while it dries. And I'll take it off. I'm gonna bring you guys a little closer. So, I look crazy right now with my little face mask. But, so I just wanted to explain, like, I don't think there should be a competition at all with CF. Nobody's competing. Like, it's not a competition at all, and people try to make it a competition, like on YouTube, like, oh, my CF's worse than yours. Like, we all have it, and we all go through horrible, horrible, horrible things. We all go through the same procedures. I mean, everyone with CF is different, you know? Nobody's the same. Every person has different symptoms. Nobody in the CF community has the same symptoms or goes through the same thing or deals with stuff the same way. Everyone deals with stuff differently. I put it over my nose ring. Oops. But everyone deals with stuff differently. And I guess the people that try and be in competition, that's how they deal with their life. Like, if someone says, oh, my PFTs were 70 today, that's low for me. And someone were to comment and say, oh my gosh, are you complaining about that? I'm in the 20s. You should be happy. You shouldn't be feeling bad with PFTs that high. That's not true whatsoever. I'm just taking off right there because it's irritating my nose. That's not true whatsoever at all. Because my PFTs could be in the hundreds, which they haven't been in a long, long time. And I could feel horrible. Or my PFTs could be in the 60s, and I could feel great. I do not think that PFTs play the main factor. They play some of the factor, of course, because if your PFTs are in, like, the 20s, you're sick. You're very sick. But I do not think that it should be a competition. I do not think that we should compare each other to each other and, like, be like, well, this happened to me, why isn't this happening to you? Or, it didn't hurt me, it shouldn't hurt you. Like, when I got my port, and people were saying, oh, it didn't hurt me, I don't know why it's hurting you so bad, it shouldn't be hurting you. Well, it hurt, and it was one of the worst pains I've ever felt in my life. And for you to tell someone that they are wrong, and to make someone not feel verified, and make someone feel like they're lying, and make someone feel like try to make them feel like they're lying when they know for a fact that they're in pain. Or, like, when I told my doctor that I was in really, like, I was in a lot of pain, which I can't stand some of my peds doctors, peds pulmonary, I can't stand some of them. I said, I'm in a lot of pain. I'm in the worst pain I've ever felt in my life. And he said, well, your therapist is coming to talk to you today. So maybe that'll help, like, saying that, like, it's in my head, because he knows that I have anxiety. So he was basically saying that it was in my head. And he was talking about how I have anxiety and stuff, and I was like, it's not anxiety. I'm in literal pain. And, like, people don't understand that there is a difference between that. And it's really important to not treat people as one. Like, you shouldn't compare someone to another. You should compare to them to their self, you know? You should trust what they are telling you, unless you know that they lie a lot, you know? Like, you should trust your patient. You should trust what someone is telling you. If someone's posting on Facebook and they don't feel good, and they're saying they don't feel good, and they said that their PFTs are down, which is in the 70s, and that's high for you, but it's low for them. Then, dude, pray for them. Don't say, oh, well, that's real high for me. I wish my PFTs were that high. You shouldn't be complaining. Don't do that. That's very, very, very rude, and it makes people feel like crap. It makes you feel like, well, I shouldn't be complaining then because, you know, like, I don't feel good, but people are telling me that, like, how to feel, basically. Like, it, don't tell someone how to feel. Like, just don't. And I see people on my Instagram, I see them arguing on Instagram about, like, how they feel. Like, if someone says they don't fucking feel good, then they don't fucking feel good, and you need to leave them alone. Excuse my language, but I think it's ridiculous when you tell someone how to feel. When someone says they don't feel good, then they don't feel good. They know their bodies better than you do. You are not in their head. You don't know what they are feeling. So don't. Don't do it. It's annoying. I just started this CF community. I just started. And I swear, if that starts happening to me, I will go off on somebody. I mean, and they will be blocked, of course. But don't give them, you know, like, don't let them ruin your day. Don't let them get in your head and be like, well, is it all in my head? You know, it's not in your head. If you don't feel good, you don't feel good. And you should never feel like, no one should ever make you feel like it's in your head. I'm sorry, this got real deep, but this is something that I feel like it should be said. Like, I remember when my PFTs used to be in the high, like, 90s and 100s, and I would feel bad, but people would be like, how do you feel bad with your PFTs being that high? And I would be like, well, like, I just don't feel good, you know? But when you don't feel good, you don't feel good, and that's not anyone else's, if they're not, like, a, well, I mean, some doctors are even wrong about things. If a doctor's telling you how to feel, if a person is telling you how to feel, then you just ignore them and you go on with your day, or you tell them how it is and you go on with your day. You should never have to feel like you're wrong. You just shouldn't. It's not okay. Some moisturizer on now that I took off that mask. And this moisturizer is just Neutrogena moisturizer. I'm almost out. I gotta get some more. But yeah, like I said, don't ever let people make you feel like you are wrong and that it is in your head, because it's not in your head. There is something wrong if you are in pain, or if you don't feel good, or if something keeps happening to you and you keep telling the doctor something's wrong, and they don't believe you, then you keep on going to people and you find out what is wrong. Because when I was little, I got diagnosed with CF at 3.5 years old. My mom kept taking me to doctors and kept taking me to the doctor, and they kept saying, there's nothing wrong with her. She has asthma. Like, it's just asthma and allergies. And they would, like, give me nebulizers, give me allergy shots, and they kept saying, there's nothing wrong with her. Like, stop bringing her back. And they started to, like, call my mom crazy. And my, like, grandma was, like telling her, like, you're crazy. Like, stop taking her to the doctor. She's fine. My mom knew there was something wrong. Even though I was her first child and she had never had a kid before, she knew there was something wrong. And you know what? She kept on taking me and she kept on taking me, and she finally found a doctor that was like, maybe she has cystic fibrosis. And they tested me for the cystic fibrosis, and I was at the hospital. They used the sweat test. That was back when they did the sweat test. It's like they put these metal plates on your wrist and wrap it up, and they shock you, and it hurts really bad. But and I remember having to get it done. But they said, "Oh, she doesn't even look sick. She probably won't have it." You do not say that to somebody. You just don't. You don't say that. But they told my mom, they said, "She don't look sick. She don't have CS. She don't look sick." They called my mom back with the results, and they told her on the phone, yeah, she has cystic fibrosis. And my mom, like, broke down and, like, freaked out, because, you know, everyone was telling her for so long there's nothing wrong with her. I mean, she was relieved, but she was scared to death, you know, to know that I have CF and, like, the unknown of CF. And, like, she didn't know how I was gonna, like, what I was gonna have to do. But it was also, it was great to know what was wrong with me and to take me to the hospital and take me to the doctor and, like, get treated. Finally, I started to get the bags under my eyes, dark circles. I couldn't gain weight. I was so sick. But I have a good memory, so I remember when I was little feeling horrible. I remember I was always so sick. But once they found out what was wrong with me, I felt so much better. I remember I would cry on the floor with my stomach hurting so bad. I remember once they finally found out I needed enzymes and everything, and they helped me so much. And I had to put them in applesauce at first, break them open, and put them in applesauce every time I would eat, because I couldn't swallow pills. But I learned how to swallow pills at 4.5 years old. And the first time I ever went in the hospital was when I was, it was on my 5th birthday, the first time I ever went in the hospital. And I've been in and out of the hospital ever since my 5th birthday. And I just think that's crazy to me. Like, it's just crazy, you know, because you trust yourself. If you have a feeling that something is wrong, then you do something about it, and you don't give up. You don't ever give up, because you are right. I mean, there's also times that people are wrong, you know, and that's okay. But I mean, you do what you think is right. And so I think that's all for this video. I'm gonna take this camera off. So I think that's all for this video. I will, I don't know when this video will be up. I might upload it today. But thank you so much for watching. If you watched through this whole video, I know it was a little long, but I wanted to just talk to you guys and chat with you guys for a little bit. My voice is still really raspy. I have that CF raspy voice. But like I said, thank you so much for watching, and I would love it if you would subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. Don't give it a thumbs down. Please. I need to get my intro. My music therapist, sorry, I keep talking. I can't shut up. But my music therapist, she wrote me a jingle for this channel, for my intro, and I'm trying to figure out how to use it and how to put it in my video. So it might be in this video. I don't know yet, but you'll see. So, thank you so much for watching, and subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up, and keep on watching my videos. They will get better, I promise. But thank you so much for the support and watching. Thank you so much.